Deanna, how's it going, girlfriend? Okay, so you wanted a twin flame reading, but I'm going to expand on it a bit for you. So I'm going to pull the regular, four cards, feminine, four masculine, and then five for the centered energy. But instead of the heart, like the shared union card, I'm going to do a crystal ball for you. Okay, so but we will start with the twin flame first. So in your recent past position, Eight of Cups, emotional withdrawal. So this is finally being ready to move on from emotionally draining situations. And it's a pilgrimage to find yourself, your truth, your higher calling. And I love how, his shadow is lit up like a rainbow. His aura. So, yeah, it's a beginning. It's finding your truth. Okay, the recent past for the masculine, Seven of Wands, stand your ground. So he's starting to see his higher calling, his truth, and stand up for his values, his core beliefs. And find his power in order to make his dreams, his desires, a reality. So it's never giving up, never surrendering, and being the king of the hill, basically. So finding his power. Your present position, intuition, high priestess, badass. So you're intuitive, psychic, you. Go within and listen to your own inner knowing, your inner voice to guide you. And you're connected to the collective consciousness, to source. And yeah, you're being represented as like a goddess, basically, the divine feminine in her 5D in this very peaceful, blissful state, present moment. You were also the gatekeeper between the conscious world and the subconscious. So you are able to see deep beneath the surface of things, see the real deal. Masculine's present, truth. So this is a grand awakening. This is realizing that your entire life has just been a movie played out in your own mind. None of it is real. It is your attachments to the ego and to the material world that makes you believe these stories and these roles. So the awakening is a detachment from that and a realization of your spiritual authenticity, your truer, higher calling. And so usually this represents significant changes going on in the environment and having to make decisions and weighing those decisions very carefully. So the seven here of wands is also, it's a spiritual card. So there's like, a glint of recognition of like a consciousness coming into your spiritual understanding, and then we got a grand awakening in the present. Near future, nice, lover's card. Yeah, baby. So this is a twin flame card, but it is not actual union, and it's longing for union. Recognizing your twin, seeing your reflection, and wanting that union, wanting to come together. Oh my God, heart chakra for the masculine, opened to receive and give love completely. How beautiful. And it's all based on a spiritual awakening. And that's the whole deal with the twin flame. It is the activation of the heart chakra that moves that energy to your crown chakra. Third eye, it's that given, like an even exchange of energy between you and your twin that opens you up. The heart chakra is the powerhouse behind consciousness. And final outcome for you, Six of Pentacles, material and spiritual prosperity. So this is having a balance between the material world and the spiritual world. It is a grounding energy, but also feeling of abundance, doing hard work in the 3D and manifesting your dreams into reality and then continuing to build on top of that. So this is like a cohabitation card for me as well. It's the sharing of each other's lives in the 3D. It's making a decision to share each other's world in the physical. Okay, final outcome for the masculine, solar plexus chakra. Finding your strength again, your power, your will, your determination in order to live your highest authentic self, your higher purpose. But really pushing forward towards what you desire most, your passions, your spark. Okay, the energy that you're bringing into the union. Three of Wands, partnerships and alliances. It's coming together as one to make a shared dream or vision a reality. So it's working together. So there's a sense that you're reaching out to your masculine, not only having a balance in the physical and being connected at the heart chakra, but having that spiritual connection. Here we got that you as in the 5D reaching out to your masculine with this wands, which is a 5D. Yeah, 5D, sorry. And here we got nothing but chakras activated. It's beautiful. All right, so what is he bringing in? Oh my God, another one. Third eye chakra. Wow. So once again, like I was saying, it is, you know, the heart chakra is the activation of your higher self. Your expansion begins with opening your heart. And then the third eye chakra and, you know, the crown chakra. And it's, again, that energy exchange between two people who love each other dearly. So the third eye chakra is your inner seeing. It is going within, using your intuition, your higher listening, you know, seeing visions, synchronicities, experiencing otherworldly connections, connecting with somebody through the collective, through source, and awakening that third eye, your intuition. So he's really like getting activated. That's crazy. I've never seen so many chakras. Okay, so foundation card. Suffering in silence, Nine of Swords. It's a shared energy. So there's a feeling that you both have, you feel like you can't move forward. This energy is an oppressing energy that's coming from the outside. So it's pushing down on both of you, feeling, making you both feel like you're trapped and unable to move forward. However, this is a nine, which means that it's nearing the completion of the cycle, so that you are turning towards the light. So you're letting go of those negative thoughts that are caging you. Crowning, recognition and reward. So this is a grounding energy. It is the fruits of your labor. You're starting to see signs of it, and you're being recognized for the work that you've done. So there's a sense of an illumination as well, standing on the podium and being recognized for your, you know, not only the grounding but the enlightenment, awakening, making your higher dreams reality in the 3D world. All right, so I'm going to move these over and we will do a crystal ball for you. Just going to look at the bottom of the deck also for the overall energy. Triumph, chariot. So this is going after your dreams, your destiny, your higher purpose, your vision. And this is a water card, so it's something that emotionally charges you, makes you happy and excited and feel lots of feels. So that's the overall energy, is, you know, going after that dream, finding that strength and that power to make it happen. And it's an emotional, something that awakens you spiritually. Okay, so let me just give these a quick shuffle. So the crystal ball is a 5x5 grid. They are going, it's going to be a distant past, recent past, present, near future, and distant future. There's going to be four cards that represent the main energies of the reading, and then one center card that represents the message from the universe. So it's generally a genderless spread unless the cards say otherwise. So every card represents both of your energy. Okay, first cornerstone card, distant past position, Ace of Cups, brand new beginning of love, being open to giving and receiving love, healing your heart, letting go of the past, cornerstone card. Next, Queen of Cups, water energy, and it represents being open and receptive to love, giving it freely and not expecting anything in return. But it's like that holding energy, holding space of love. And this, she's also very intuitive, psychic. So far, two cups, love. Nine of Swords again. So this was the foundation energy that you both shared. So it's feeling trapped in fear, anxiety, nightmares, unable to sleep, just thoughts encaging you. But again, it's a nine, which means nearing the completion of feeling that way. Three of Wands. This is starting to see success. You know, the Three of Pentacles has to do with earth energy, grounding your foundation, making your dreams, you know, starting to happen in the 3D world, whereas the Three of Wands talks about your highest vision, you know, reaching for the stars in terms of your spirituality and starting to see that payoff. But there's also a sense of waiting that is required, but feeling hopeful. Cornerstone, Ten of Swords, cutting the negative away. So we got a Nine of Swords here, Ten as a cornerstone. Ten represents completion, the end. So it is a death and rebirth. It is a dark night of the soul, but from it, there is a new, brand new beginning. Recent past, Eight of Cups again. So that came in your recent past position, right down here. So it's deciding to walk away from negative emotions. You're going off on a pilgrimage in order to find yourself. Seven of Cups, feeling confused, not seeing your way clearly, too many options, wondering if, you know, what you've experienced in the past was just an illusion. But this is an emotionally charged card. Spirit is asking you to follow your heart in order to find the answer. So there's a sense that, you know, there was some confusion, and one of you finally decided to go towards love, towards that heart-centered activation, you know, true love energy. Because of the fact that you're following your heart. Next, Eight of Swords. Again, the sense of imprisonment, inability to move forward. It's an oppressive energy coming from the outside, stopping you from moving forward. But it's just an illusion. You can release yourself from that prison. They're just thoughts. magician, master manifester, make your dreams a reality in the 3D world. Actually pull thoughts from source, from consciousness, and ground that, make it happen. So there's a sense of jailbreak here, you know, for the Three of Wands in the past, and then we got this poof, like an epiphany, an awakening, a release from the prison, from the confusion, and a journey to find oneself. King of Swords, so this could represent an air sign, but this represents a mental clarity, a decision, authority, a detachment from emotions in order to make decisions based on your truth, unencumbered by emotions. So it's mental control, being the pinnacle of control. And it also represents communication. So from that ending, there was truth and a release. Present position, Six of Cups, somebody from the past coming back, a return. And this is also reminiscing about someone you loved fairly, very dearly, and holding those memories close to your heart. And the love that was experienced between the two of you was pure and innocent, free. So there's a release, a walk away towards someone that you love dearly. Knight of Pentacles. So this is my favorite knight. It is a forward movement. It's a very slow movement, but it is a guaranteed arrival, guaranteed success. Present position. So there's a sense that he's almost there, arrival in the 3D world. Next card is zero point card. Is the main message from the universe. Four of Cups. So it's a shared energy. Even though there's a masculine here, I'm sensing that you both feel this way, that things are not moving forward fast enough, that you're longing for union, to return to one another, and you just feel like it's not happening. So that's what's caused that sense of engagement and fear and anxiety, because there's a longing, a wanting for that arrival to happen. And it's going to happen. Wish granted card. This is the Star card. So you sent out an intention in the past with the Magician card to be released from this cage, this confusion, and this fear, cut it away. And the Star card is here to say that the worst of it is over now. Now is the time to rest and heal your heart, and not to worry, because your dreams are on its way. Five of Pentacles. So this is shooting yourself in the foot in order to be released from something, and taking a financial loss as a result of it, or just feeling like you've been left out in the cold, perhaps. I don't know. But this is right below the King of Swords and the Ten of Swords. So both sword energy, and it's telling me, you know, there was a release, a cutaway in the past that caused anxiety. It's like he's looking at her, reminiscing about this love, feeling that she inspired him, and then there is a cutaway. And it was a movement towards finding himself, but as a result, there's a sense that he encaged himself even further. There was a descent even further from the 9 to the 8. Even though there was that 10 completion, there was still that sense of imprisonment. Then another epiphany, clarity of thought, of a longing to return to that lost love, and making those steps forward towards making that happen. Dreams manifested, but it requires a loss of some kind. Three of Swords. So this is heartbreak. So walking away from a situation, that Eight of Cups, will create a sense of pain, heartbreak in the future. Page of Wands. So this is good news communication. It is gasoline being poured on the fire. It is an explosion of excitement and optimism for the future. So that right beside the Three of Swords, it's almost like a healing energy to me. Do you know what I mean? It's like once you've healed your heart, I guess. I'm not too sure. But it just seems to me like there's this surprising, exciting news that comes in. And maybe it's because, you know, there's that sense of loss, not being able to reunite with your love. I don't know. I'm going to pull a Osho Zen card for that one right now and see what that's all about. Oh, okay. So one just flew out. Friendship. Two of Cups. So where's my book? Friendliness. I stopped it at 1 and 11 just now. Okay. The branches of these two flowering trees are intertwined and their fallen petals blend together on the ground in their beautiful colors. It is as if heaven and earth are bridged by love. But they stand individually, each rooted in the soil to their own connection with earth. In this way, they represent the essence of true friends, mature, easy with each other, natural. There is no urgency about their connection, no neediness, no desire to change the other into something else. This card indicates a readiness to enter the quality of friendliness. In the passage, you may notice that you're no longer interested in all kinds of dramas and romance that other people are engaged in. It is not a loss. It is a birth of higher, more loving qualities, born of the fullness of experience. It is the birth of love that is truly unconditional, without expectations or demands. Ah, I get it. So from this sense of loss, there is a rebirth. An aha moment, realization, and it's, you know, this recognition of oneself and the other, and loving that person unconditionally without being afraid of having your heart broken, you know, without wanting and longing and needing is what I'm feeling, and that's what a true twin flame connection is about. It's about loving a person enough to allow them to be who they are without strings or attachments or a need to control. It's just allowing them to be, loving them without restraint. Next, Seven of Swords. So this talks about feeling like you don't have all the information, like you're being deceived, kept in the dark about something. So that's an interesting twist. Next, Page of Pentacles. So this is putting work in 3D in order to make something a reality. So it's laying plans out. It also talks about, you know, gathering information. So it's almost like, and it could also represent communication in the 3D. So maybe, you know, something that was not known becomes known with that epiphany. Three of Pentacles again. So this was the crowning energy. So it's that solid foundation being laid. It's a start in the 3D. And it's because of this hard work that's been put into, to, you know, making your dreams realized. Especially with that Knight of Pentacles, that shows that this has been going on for quite a long time. All right, next is the cornerstone for the final row, King of Cups. Beautiful. So back there we had the Queen of Cups. beside the Ace of Cups, brand new beginning of love, cornerstone card. It is the masculine really getting in touch with his heart, opening his heart chakra. And it's a pure, innocent love, just like the Six of Cups. Same thing with that Lover's card up there. Pure, you know, deep, emotional, unconditional love that the masculine then feels. So he's taken on your Queen of Cups traits. Next, Five of Swords. So this is walking away from conflict, arguments, just negative energy, not putting yourself in the line of fire. King of Wands. So this could represent a fire energy, that's water. Could represent two different people. It's almost like there's a conflict between the two. Or a conflict causes him to step into his power even further as a King of Wands. Do you know what I mean? There's a sense of not really believing, you know, in this connection. And because of not knowing and not really trusting your heart, moving forward with that, you know, clinging to fear, it causes some questions to be raised in the near future. But ultimately, there's a choice to walk away from that negative thought again, find that mental clarity, but then become the King of Wands. And this is someone who is passionate, on fire, makes their dreams a reality and manifests them. So he is the object of desire as well. Fire. So, yeah, I mean, I'm thinking, you know, this journey for him is really about finding his power. We got stand your ground, and then we got that solar plexus chakra as an outcome. And remember the heart chakra as an outcome. So here we got that power, the fire, the King of Wands, and the heart chakra, emotions, the King of Cups. So it's like, you know, almost deciding, you know what, I'm done with whatever this negative energy is, and just deciding to finally put that to rest. You know, deciding to let fear go. Three of Cups, union, two people coming together to form love. And it is true love, pure love, and it's the celebration of love. And final cornerstone card, Two of Wands, the expansiveness of the mind, seeing things from higher perspective, realizing that you are connected to the universe, that you are the universe. And it's just opening the mind, making a decision in the past that wasn't based on fear, but instead it was based on your higher purpose and moving forward through that door and making your dreams reality. But again, there's a sense of waiting for that return. So because it's beside this Three of Cups, I'm thinking it is a finally, you know, that wait is over. Right beside that union card, it's just deciding to walk away from that conflict and out the door towards love. All right, so let me just move these back. I'm going to pull two cards from Call It, Bear, and Read, and I'm going to read those to you. Give them a quick shuffle. Okay, so for the feminine first, what additional messages do you have for Deanna and her twin flame, please? Mountain and masculine, magic prayer. Wow, I opened right to the page. Okay. You have the capacity to flow around any obstacle. This is the time to adapt. Sometimes you'll come across what appears to be an insurmountable obstacle, like a huge mountain that separates you from your success. You might think that you might think that climbing it or chiseling away at it is the answer, but why take such treacherous, tedious approach? Be like the rivers that flow around a mountain naturally. You'll move past this obstacle relatively quickly if you choose the easy way around. This is the time to adapt to your circumstances. If you decide to climb, remember to take one step at a time, opting for the next right action. Yeah, this reading really seemed to be centered on the masculine energy. Lots of kings going on here. Three kings, and then we have you just holding that space open, that loving, receptive cup, which will draw your masculine towards you. Magic prayer. Speak your prayer, listen for the answer, act in faith. When you see the magic prayer card, it is a reminder that your prayers will be answered. Spirit is always waiting to help you and to heal you when you're in need. That said, the best prayer is, "Thy will be done through me, thy will not mine be done." Conscious contact with your higher power is achieved through the ritual of prayer and meditation. Speak and listen to the divine force within the field of creation. Surrender your wishes and desires to spirit. You may not get what you want, but you will surely get what you need. Your destiny awaits you. As long as you keep in conscious contact with your higher power, be assured that you are on the right path. So he is on the right path. He's trying to make his dreams manifest into reality, into the 3D. All right, so I hope this made sense, and I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know if it resonated. Cheers. Peace.